Good afternoon, 47. Your destination is Marrakesh, Morocco, where civil riots are looming. Your targets are private banker Klaus Strandberg and army general Reza Zedan, two of the conspirators in a sinister plot to overthrow Morocco's fragile government. Strandberg, a former bank CEO who stole billions of dollars worth of savings from the Moroccan people, was facing trial for investment fraud. But early this morning, a band of heavily armed mercenaries freed Strandberg from his prison transport, resulting in the death of several police officers. Strandberg now takes refuge at his native Swedish consulate, in front of which crowds of angry protesters have gathered, demanding his handover to Moroccan authorities. We believe General Zedan orchestrated Strandberg's escape to infuriate the public and spark nationwide riots, allowing Zedan to impose martial law. Operating out of a field HQ at a nearby abandoned school, he will no doubt use the riots to depict the Rabat government as weak and inept, and persuade the general staff to support a fully-fledged military coup in the name of national security. Our client, building contractor Hamilton Lowe, who stands to lose a fortune in government contracts, has hired us to prevent the coup d'etat. To do so, you need to paralyze Zedan's rebel forces and prevent the riots from escalating further, hence the double contract. This is quite the political powder keg, 47, so be careful. The fate of a nation is at stake. I will leave you to prepare. Welcome to Marrakesh, 47. The situation grows more tense by the minute. The consulate is under lockdown, but the protests are only a stone throw away from full-blown riots, and Zedan won't hesitate to unleash his troops. So whatever you're planning, time is of the essence. Good luck, 47.
Hate the sweet
and handsome.
You haven't seen the news?
Strandberg.
You know who I mean?
Yeah, I'm not that dumb.
Yeah, hi there. Remember me? Rudy? My wife sent me back to get those lamps.
Lovely day. Like
them. You want a lamp?
Step in. Take a look at my rare lamp.
What the hell are Crystal Dawn doing here?
All right there. Hey, slow down. All right there.
I could just about strangle Jerry. Stomach cramps. What kind of...
Thanks for responding so quickly. We never expected something like this. Not Denver.
You made it. Most impressive, 47. Now to locate Klaus Strandberg.
Massage expert Connie Engstrom. Report at the reception desk. That was Connie Engstrom. Please go to the reception desk.
According to the appointment schedule, Klaus Strandberg has booked a massage to relieve his back pains. No doubt all that time in prison has caused muscle stiffness.
I salute you,
the masseur, who works at a local clinic, has apparently already checked into the building.
Six small screws and five sort of smaller screws. Five. It is not fair. It isn't. You can't keep me in here under these circumstances. If I had known... Well, that's easy for you to say. You're not the one supposed to be doing deep tissue massage in a freaking war zone, okay? It is that bad, Donald, it is. Believe me. Yeah, no, do not put me on hold. Oh, boy. I really need a cigarette.
Nice and good!
Connie Engstrom, monsieur, here for an appointment with Klaus Strandberg.
Oh, Mr. Engstrom. Please proceed to the massage room. It's upstairs on the right. I'll inform Mr. Strandberg.
Klaus Strandberg.
What the hell?
Go to the massage room.
Excuse me. I just gotta check you.
Hey, wake up.
Klaus Strandberg.
Okay, whoa. Sir, sorry, this is just going to take a second.
I found a body. I think it's a dead body.
Thank you. I'll check it out.
All right, you're good. You're good to go.
Oh, good. There you are. Klaus Strandberg. Call me Klaus. So, to the massage room, shall we? This muscle. It's killing me, and I don't have a lot of time.
Lead the way.
Hey, you shaved your head, Connie? Nice.
Well done, 47. I will leave Strandberg in your capable hands.
Ah, that's the ticket. I tell you, nothing makes you tense like thousands of people wanting to kill you. Hell, people are funny. The fact is, if those morons had bothered to learn the first thing about market investments, my scheme would never have worked. Greed and ignorance, my friend. Those are the cornerstones to any good con. But you see, easy money, that's all people care about. So they can drive their ridiculous urban SUVs and drink wine on a Thursday, on a Tuesday, whatever, and tell each other how they've made it. It's pathetic.
target down. Next up, Reza Zaidan.
Connie, what happened to your beautiful hair? Connie?
Aromatherapy? Okay, never mind.
Mr. Ink? Oh, come on, man. No one's getting any massages in here. Scram!
Thank you.
Okay.
Check it out.
Sure.
General Zaden keeps coming down here to check on the prisoner. I hear they were close, so what'd he do, poor bastard?
The way I heard it, his brother was one of the policemen who got killed when the Mercs attacked Strandberg's prison transport this morning. So he got cold feet, tried to blow the lid on the whole operation.
Not smart.
According to the soldiers, the condemned prisoner in the cell was a close friend of Zaden. However, when his brother, a Marrakesh police officer, was killed during Strandberg's breakout, the prisoner decided to betray Zaden and go public. Alas, he was caught before he could thwart the coup d'etat.
But, pretty human. I'm just glad I wasn't picked for the firing squad.
I hear you.
You're in. Good work, 47. Now to locate General Zaden.
Wanted man's a traitor, and that's all there is to it. Probably got his cold feet about the operation. Try to wrap it up. That's the cap.
Still on guard, dude.
That's why I'm here.
I mean, sure,
Zayden does date some beautiful women, I'll give him that. And they sure seem to flock around with this chiseled old Martian.
That is General Reza Zaydan, Keeper of the Peace.
What? No salute.
Are you here to gloat, Reza? Thought you had a government to overthrow.
You should always embrace the small pleasures. You sold us outside.
And I would do it again. Proudly. You're a monster, Reza.
I am sorry about your brother. He wasn't supposed to have been at the prison transport. But you know what they say about omelets.
I was never even there.
You keep saying that. No, I hear what you're saying, and I completely agree. Your feelings are... I never meant to break that. I'm sorry, I thought I had said that.
Mr. Orlando, how is our favorite banker? Don't worry. If the Kingsley interview doesn't whip them all into a frenzy, I will take more direct measures. No. Our employers have no mind to reward idiotic behavior. Strandberg was given a position of power. He only had to keep his head down with whatever the heralds told him. $1 billion investment story is not exactly part of the arrangement. No, my men will put Strandberg on a plane to South America, and somewhere along the way, they'll give him a drop.
Yes, the Sea Lord.
And they say sweet things.
Thank you.
alike, Wanda. That's rather... Well, that's judgment. You know that. All I'm saying is... Wanda? Wanda? Wanda, if you would let me finish, I... Wanda? You're right. You're absolutely right. I'm not arguing, Wanda. I'm putting up an argument here. I'm just... Honey, no, Wanda. Listen, that was one time. I...
Comfortable sight? I just love what you've done with the place.
Go fuck yourself, Ressa.
Defiant to the end.
Good for you.
Both targets down. Now head towards an exit.
Go ahead. compromised. But I don't understand. There is no sign of forced entry, no alarms, nothing.
One of my people has gone missing in Johannesburg. A key bearer.
I wish I'd been informed. Still, the system demands two keys, and the rest are all accounted for.
Except for your late predecessors.
Comp? But his plane went down over the Pacific. It was an accident.
Such was the conclusion at the time. Yes. People die, Mr. Fannin. Happens all the time, even to us. It seems like a conspiracy. Probably isn't. And yet, the failed coup in Morocco, the ether virus. Someone knows about us. There was a pattern and I failed to see it. Providence is under attack.
How much was that?
Money? Not money, Mr. Fannin. Information on all of our assets and operatives, like you. Dig a trench, Director, and make it a deep one, because none of you are safe anymore.